Let's see what are triggers are. Triggers are the statements in SQL, PLSQL you can say. These are the statements that are executed automatically by the system as a side effect of a modification to the database. Triggers are statements that we use normally to avoid any modification into the database system. A trigger is a statement that is executed automatically by the system as a side effect of the modification into the database by unauthorized users. Right. Then there are certain conditions to be met to after trigger in the SQL database. I'll take this first two important points. That is, when the trigger gets executed, you should remember ECA, short form for triggers. E stands for event. C stands for condition. And A stands for action. Whenever someone asks you, you should remember this, and this should come to your mind. What is ECA? ECA stands for event, condition, and action. Whenever you design a trigger, you must think of these three things, that is event, condition, and action. We have to write a trigger in such a way that there must be a condition, then only the trigger should execute it. And once the trigger is executed, what action the trigger is going to take, that should be planned beforehand. So to understand triggers, let's take some real life examples. Smoke detector, you can say, or fire detector is there in your house. Now tell me, what is the event for it? In real life, if you have fire detector or smoke detector, then what would be the event for this? What is the condition? That will ring a bell only when, or siren only when, there is a fire inside your house or there is a smoke inside your house, right? And it will be automatically executed, right? You never press a button to make the fire extinguisher on, right? So it's an automatic system. It works whenever there is a fire inside your house. It gets automatically triggered and a siren will come. Then it will be an alert for all the people inside the house or in an organization so that they can go out of the house. What action should be taken? That is to be planned. So when the fire is detected, action is what? Ring the bell or the siren for sending an alert message to all the people inside the house. Right. So here, to design a trigger mechanism, we must specify the condition under which trigger is to be executed. So condition is very, very important just to trigger that trigger. Specify the action to be taken when the trigger gets executed. So once the condition is met, you need to give the action also. So inside the code, you need to give the action also. Till now, any question in this one? Have you understood? We are going to design one trigger now on our own database. Any question till now to understand what is trigger is? We'll take a small example. Now, what would be the event for a trigger in databases? It can be insert, delete, or update. It means all the manipulation, the data manipulation language commands comes under event. Trigger can update can be restricted to specific attribute. You can restrict the people to not to update your database or not to delete any records from your database or not to insert any unwanted data in your database. That we can decide in designing the trigger. There are different types of trigger, column level and table level trigger that we'll see later. Now let's see a small example in which, suppose I have a table, student table in my database, that we already created student in the practicals also. We have a student table and there is some very important information in the table. And suppose I am the person who handles that particular database, and suppose I am going on leave on Tuesday, or what is the day today? It is Friday. Suppose I am going on leave on Friday, then I don't want any person, outside person or any unauthorized person, to do any modification in my table. My table should remain as it is inside the database till I resume the job, right? So how to design such trigger? It means I am going to protect my entire table. See, there is difference between trigger and constraints. Constraints are applied on columns, right? Here we are applying everything. Means we are applying a rule on a table, entire table. So I don't want to do anything, anybody to do anything in my table. So triggers have their own importance, whereas constraints have their own importance. Constraints are the rules that we impose on the attributes, whereas triggers we can apply on attributes, or triggers we can apply on records, triggers we can apply on entire tables as per our need. So here in this particular example, I want to apply trigger. You can give any name to the trigger, say trigger is T1, which will not allow any modification on Tuesday. So I'll take this example. Create a trigger T1 on student table, which will not allow any modification on, say, if you write Tuesday, then I need to modify the system date to show you the correct result. But today is Friday, so I'll put it Friday. Suppose I am going on leave today, I'll make it Friday. It means that whenever the next Friday will come, automatically this table gets locked. Or today also it gets locked. Nobody can do any modification into student table, right? Then how to design the trigger? The statement to create the trigger is this one: create or replace trigger. T1 is the name that I have given to you. The trigger, create or replace trigger T1. Now, what is the event? Event is this time. Before anything like insertion or updation or deletion, insert or update or delete on which table? Table is student. So I'll replace here. I will make it as student. Now, this is our event. First line is the name of a trigger. Second line is the event when you want to execute it. Now, here in the begin and end block, we have a condition. That is, toCar is the function which is going to convert the system date, and from the system date we'll going to pick the day information only. So toCar will going to fetch the system date, out of which I want to only focus on DY means day information. Day is Friday, so I will make it Friday. So first three characters it will take always. The way we have seen in date data type, when I write MON, it is first three characters of the month. The DY gives you first three characters of the day. So here I am going to check is if took care of system date. System means that means today days of today's date, comma DY. It will take first three characters today's date. Today is Friday, right? So it will take FRI. So left hand side is FRI, is Friday, is equals to Friday. FRI on the right hand side, it is matching. Then you need to print the error message of a trigger. You need to print an error message of a trigger. What error message that trigger will going to print as a side effect of the database modification. So I have to write this line, that is raise underscore application underscore error, and in bracket you need to pass two parameters. One is the error number and second is the error message. So what is this raise underscore application underscore error? It is the standard statement in Oracle which allows us to print the error messages similar to Oracle format. So what is the Oracle format of displaying the errors? Let me show you on the compiler. You can see the previous errors that has occurred before. You can see any error that has been given by the system to us. Here, this is the number ORA-06550. It's the error number. It is showing me the error message that this is encountered symbol this when the expecting one of the following. Like this, it is a little message given by Oracle software. So we can have any minus number, negative number, you can put any number that you can give, but it should not be in the range of the Oracle errors. So I have given some large number, say 20,001. You can give any larger number, a negative number as the error number for this particular message. This is our user defined message, right? So I have given 20,001. Comma is the error number for my message, and my message for this is cannot manipulate today. You cannot manipulate this table, student table, today is the message that I have to print. Whenever anybody wants to modify my student table on Friday, he will get this message, right? The way we have seen error messages are coming in constraints. Suppose if you declared roll number as the primary key and say roll number 1 data is already there in the database, when somebody wants to insert roll number 1, then you get the error message on your screen that primary key violation, right? That was the standard error by the Oracle software. Now we want to print our own error message with Oracle error messages, and this will be recorded in the data dictionary, this error message, right? So this will come only when this trigger gets violated, T1 trigger gets violated. Whenever the violation happens on your screen, you'll find the error number as this one and the message as cannot manipulate today. And now I want to close the end if statement. So I'll use endif, and I want to close now the begin. I want to close the program. So I will use end. So how many lines of code I have written to just lock my table on Friday? Only four or five lines of code, right? Let's take it again. First line is for giving the name to the trigger. Second line is event before which operation, insert or update or delete on student. Then begin, you know, and end, you know, right? So this is the block in which you need to write the code. And how many lines I have written to just print my message? Only three lines. If took care of sysdate comma dy equal to Friday, then raise underscore application underscore error and the error number comma the error message. And if that's it, let's try it on the system. Let me first of all check, is student table available in my database or not? How I am going to check students? Let me know. Tell me how to check whether student table is there in my database or not. Write your answer in the chat box. Okay, Tushar is saying describe student. Select, no, there is no command, such commands, show tables. I'll write. Select star from tab or table, tab, or you can write complete tab or table. So this will going to show me all the tables, maybe a trigger or maybe a view or it may be a table. Everything it will be this, it will going to display me. See this, there are so many tables. Remember this command, select star from tab is the command to check how many tables are there. Now I want to know whether student table is there or not. So Shreya has given the answer, that is select query. You can select or describe student, that is also okay. I will try this, describe student. Yes, it is available. Select star from student. Just to know how many records are there. See, it is showing me that there are 6 records into the table. It means that student table is there in my database. Now I am applying this particular constant. I want to apply this particular constant so that it will not allow any modification on Friday. Okay. Already the records are there. There are 6 records are there, and let's try this trigger so that it will not allow any modification on this student table. See the screen, students. I have written the code of trigger T1. And now it will show you the message that the trigger is successfully created. Trigger is created successfully. Right. Today is, let's check the date. Today is Friday. Correct. Here, if you see, 12 is the Friday. And let's try to insert some record into this, whether it will allow me or not. Insert into student values. So 11 is the roll number and name is Tushar. Semicolon. So this is a simple insert statement that I have written. I want to insert this record whose roll number is 11 and name is Tushar. Press enter. Now check the result on the screen. I will take it into the notepad so that you can view it properly. This was the error message that I received when I tried to insert the record of Tushar. This was the error message. See this. Everything is proper, the syntax is proper, but where is the error? Error at line number 1 means in this particular line here itself there is an error. It is because this error is caused because of ORA hyphen 20001. It's not the Oracle number, it's our number. This is the number that we have given for a trigger in the message, you can see. And the message that we have given for this particular action is cannot manipulate today. Right? You can check. Here it is. Right? So our trigger got triggered inside the system because today is Friday. Somebody wants to manipulate my table, and as a reply, trigger has given his an error message, that is ORA hyphen 20001 cannot manipulate today. And another error message is given by Oracle system. This is Oracle system error message. At system.t1. What is T1? Here, T1 is the trigger that we have created. T1 is the trigger that we have created. And it is available at line number 3 into the trigger definition. Then the last error message is very important. Check this. ORA hyphen the another number, say. But what is the message? Error during the execution of the trigger system.t1. It means that this particular message, this error has happened because of the trigger T1. And if somebody wants to know what is that error message, he must know what is T1, right? He must know how T1 has been defined. If it is a trigger and how it has been defined. He should go into the, if he is a hacker, he will go into the system and he will try to search for T1. But then again, there Oracle has the highest level of security. He will never get anything to crack this type of actions. Okay, so this type of security we can provide on the entire table or on the entire database also. We can do that. So highest level of security can be provided via triggers to our database. So this is the best example that I have shown you, a small example you can say, on student table, which does not allow anybody to modify their table, the student table, on Friday. Is it possible?